Tea Party congressman, Alan West of Florida. I must confess, when I see anyone with an Obama bumper sticker, I recognize them as a threat to the gene pool. They believe in loving America, but hating its government. Conservative activist, Grover Norquist.
I don't want to abolish government. I simply want to reduce it to the size where I could drag it into the bathroom and drown it in the bathtub.
And they believe that anyone who disagrees with the Tea Party has sinister anti-American motives.
The objective of the liberals is to destroy this country. The objective of the liberals is to make America mediocre.
Most of all, you must never, under any circumstance, seek to reach a compromise with your opponent or do any of what Democrats and genuine Republicans both call governing. Senate Minority Leader Mitch McConnell.
Our top political priority over the next 2 years should be to deny President Obama a second term.
And one other plank in the Tea Party platform. If you're poor, it means you're either too lazy or too stupid to be rich. Here's Andre Bauer, Tea Party leader and Lieutenant Governor of South Carolina. My grandmother was not a highly educated woman, but she told me as a small child to quit feeding stray animals. You know why? Because they breed. During Tea Party rallies and campaign speeches, we've been told that America was founded as a Christian nation, and that if the Founding Fathers were here today, they'd tell us so. Here's John Adams in the Treaty of Tripoli. As the government of the United States is not, in any sense, founded on the Christian religion. And here's Thomas Jefferson. That our civil rights have no dependence on our religious opinions. And here's the First Amendment to the U.S. Constitution. Congress shall make no law respecting an establishment of religion. What's more frightening than the perversion of our great history is that sensible, smart, strong Republicans, the very men and women who should be standing up to radical fundamentalism, are so frightened of losing primary battles to religious zealots that they've thrown in the towel on sanity. So we get this.
Yes, that the Constitution established the United States of America as a Christian nation.
It's ironic because the biggest enemy of the phony Republican isn't Nancy Pelosi or Harry Reid or Hillary Clinton or Barack Obama. It's this man. He said, heal the sick, feed the hungry, care for the weakest among us, and always pray in private. Ideological purity. Compromise is weakness. A fundamentalist belief in scriptural literalism. Denying science. Unmoved by facts. Undeterred by new information. A hostile fear of progress. A demonization of education.
A need to control women's bodies. Severe xenophobia. Tribal mentality. Intolerance of dissent and a pathological hatred of the U.S. government.
They can call themselves the Tea Party. They can call themselves conservatives. And they can even call themselves Republicans, though Republicans certainly shouldn't. But we should call them what they are, the American Taliban.